What's up YouTube, this is Max Square and it's another week, which means another free template Friday. We are on episode 11 and I'm giving away a free Photoshop collage template. So hopefully this will be a pretty short video. I always say that and then end up going for like 15 minutes, but I'm gonna try and keep this brief. But if you are new here, I make videos all about how to increase your productivity on your Mac, iPad, and iPhone. So if that's something you're into, consider subscribing down below and hitting that bell icon so you can get a notification whenever I upload a video. Without further ado, free template Friday. So you probably know the drill by now. We get a download, looks something like this. Now this one's a little bit different because I've included some images of the different layouts that you're gonna get. Now the reason I did this is because if I kept all the photos in Photoshop, there's so many smart objects in there that the file was like 1.3 gigs, but now it's only 23 meg. So I'm just trying to help you guys and make it a little bit easier to download, save you some bandwidth and whatnot. And then there's a README file. I've actually linked to the specific photos that I've used as a demo if you are interested. And then if you need any help, you guys know the drill. So these are just a couple of the different layouts that you can make. I've tried to include as many different ones as possible, but again, it's super easy to customize. You can have up to about 8 photos like this layout here. This one just kind of flips it around with 2 on the top, 4 on the bottom. So let's go ahead and open this up inside of Photoshop. And like I said, this is blank because if I included the photos, it would have been really big, but it's super easy to replace them. Now, if we open up this Replace Me folder, you'll see 8 different layers in here. These are actually smart objects that you can just double click into and then drop in the photo you want to put there, and it'll update across the entire document. Like I said, you can have up to 8, so you can just do that same process. So I'm gonna go ahead and drop in some photos just so you can see what it looks like. All right, so once those photos are in there, you don't actually have to enable the Replace Me folder. It's just there for you to replace and it'll update throughout the document. So if we take a look at layout 1, you can see our photos have been added. We can go to layer 2 and layer 3, just keep going through them. And the way that I've built out each layout is that you have 2 folders, the borders and the photos. So if you feel like messing around with the positioning, like the masks, it's all using a clipping mask so you can go in there and move each one over. But then you'll also have to update the borders. So I've split that out into a separate folder. So if you want to take that out, you can. And you can keep that frame around it. That's going to be at the top of the project. You can see we have this border frame. So you can disable that if you want to just get a really clean layout. But it's meant to be really easy to switch between these different layouts because once you've added those photos, it just goes to every single layout. So we can look at this kind of vertical horizontal split. I have the 8 grid one there, and we have a different version for that, then just kind of this different crooked layout, and then that last one like I showed you guys. Now one thing to keep in mind is that you'll probably have to adjust some of the positioning of the photos. As you can see here in the middle, we're kind of missing the top of the mountains, but it's really easy to just jump in there, go to photos, you can go to the middle folder, and then all you have to do is just hit Command T and you can shift that down so you get everything that you want in the image. So in case something is being cropped out in your photo, you can just jump in there and reposition it. And that is pretty much it for this whole template. The idea behind this is that if you wanted to maybe post a couple of photos at once instead of maybe doing a slideshow, I'm thinking, you know, Instagram or Facebook, you maybe don't want people to scroll, you kind of want them to just see a snapshot. You can do that with this template. And as the name suggests, this is entirely free, so be sure to hit the link down below to get your hands on this and start messing around with it yourself. But that has been it for this video. I hope you guys all enjoyed. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.